বলা হয়েছে না, সবাই শুনে শুনে না কান পচে গেছে, আর আমার আর বলবার ইচ্ছে নেই। যাই হোক, আমি 91 সালে একটা এক্সিবিশন করেছিলাম, তখন ভেবেছিলাম একবারই করব একটা হবি থেকে, কিন্তু সেই এক্সিবিশনটা যেহেতু সবগুলো জিনিস বিক্রি হয়ে গেল, তখন আমি একটুখানি কি বলবো আত্মপ্রত্যয় হলো। তখন আমি দ্বিতীয় এক্সিবিশনটা করলাম, প্রথম এক্সিবিশনে মিডিয়াকে ডাকিনি, ডাকার কথা ভাবিও নি, দ্বিতীয় এক্সিবিশনে ডাকলাম, পরের দিন আই ওয়াজ অল ওভার।
এমন করেও গল্প তো আমি সত্যি হয়, গল্প তো সত্যিই হয়, আর সেই যে সত্যি হলো তার সবচেয়ে বড় প্রমাণ পরের জন, সামনে দিয়ে যান।
হাই, what do you want me to say? Life story. শুনো, আমি এখানে সব থেকে বড় মহিলা, হ্যাঁ, I'm going to be 80 years old in 2 months. So our story will take you,
we wish you an advance happy birthday ma'am from this calendar for you.
It'll take you 80 hours to listen to my story. Do you want to do that? Starting now. Sure, that is very kind of you, but okay, 80 years ago I was born in Karachi. I can't speak onek bhalo bangla bolte parna, shei jonno ekta ekta ingreji bolbo. I have the permission to speak in English. কিন্তু আমার এখানে যে মাই হার্ট, আই বিন ইন ক্যালকাটা ফর মোর দেন সিন্স 1962, হাফ অফ ইউ ওয়ার নট বর্ন দেন। সো ফ্রম করাচি উই কেম আফটার পার্টিশন টু ডেলি, অ্যান্ড উই কেম অ্যাজ রেফিউজিস, লিটারালি উইথ নাথিং, শুধু একটা স্যুটকেস উইথ ক্লোথস ফর অল ফাইভ অফ আস অ্যান্ড মাই মাদার্স সোয়িং মেশিন, বিকজ শি ওয়াজ এ ভেরি গুড সিমিস্ট্রেস। So we came to Delhi with absolutely nothing. God was great. My father found a job, a government job very soon. But with little money like that, the one thing that we always were taught is wipe a tear and spread a smile. Kauke jodi, if you see anybody crying, help him smile. And my mother's life was also all about that. We were 5 people. With that little money, when she would cook for 6 people. 5 of us and somebody going down the street somewhere. Always, right from the beginning. So all we have ever learned from my mother was wipe a tear and spread a smile. And all I've ever learned from my father, he empowered me when I was 5. I was the first born girl, and he was a mathematician, and he told my mother, this girl will never cook, she will only teach maths, she will work with maths. Until now, till the age of 80, I never entered the kitchen, with the grace of the Lord and my father's blessings. And it was in Delhi which played another magic trick on me. As a girl of 11, I went to Lady Irwin School, which was run by Bengali women, and my principal was Miss Sengupta. My craft teacher when I was about 11 or 12 was a Miss Lahiri, and she taught me Kantha without telling me what it was. We used to have 3 little mats in cotton, and we had to sew them up just like the old Kantha in Bengal is. And that's how I grew up, not realizing what we were doing, but we grew up like that. And then I grew up studying mathematics, I got married, I came here, and I continued to teach mathematics. I got scholarships to go abroad and so on, and I taught in Loreto Teachers Training College, maths training. And the Lord, again I call it the divine script, I had a 7-pound tumor in my abdomen, and I had to give up my job because I was not able to work anymore. And as sorry to repeat this, but in my life, everything that has happened, the Lord's grace and my mother's and father's grace, these are the 3 things that have seen me through. I went across the Calcutta Club to the Calcutta Information Center, where it said Shanti Niketan Craft Mela. I went inside and there were leather bags, and there were various other handicrafts and so on. And on one table there was this lady making the same kind of kansas that I used to make as an 11, 12 year old girl. I went up to her and I said, "Ki kocho?" She said, "Ami jane na." I said, "Ami jani. Ami korte pari, kintu tumi ki kocho ekhane?" She said, "Ami bikri korte chai." And suddenly the thought came to me that my husband had just come back from Chennai and brought me 4 white saris. I used to have my saris printed in Wellesley Street from a friend, and he must have brought them back thinking that I'll get them printed. So suddenly I said to her, I said, "Will you do the same work on a sari?" She said, "Na didi, hobe na." I said, "Kano?" She said, "Ami silk upore korte pari na, ar ami ek tak upore korte pari na. Ami teen layers chai, ek upore hobe na." I said, "Shuno, ami tomake amar garite niye jacchi, osho barite esho, ami tomake jinish debo, taka age theke dekhe rakhbo, tomar kichu oshubidha hobe na." Anyway, after much argument, they agreed, they came home, and I made them sit around a table, gave them mishti and shinghada and sab kichu. And I don't like white too much, so I went and dyed my saris in tea. My husband was in tea business, so we had a lot of tea in the house. So I dyed my saris in 3 different shades of beige, and these girls stood in my garden and dried the saris. And then they said, "Didi, ki hobe?" I said, "Ami jani na, ami to artist noi. Ami shuddho mathematician, ami ar kichu jani na." So they said, then I thought about the paisleys Miss Dairi had made me do. So I said, "Dutu pich boro boro koro, ekto lal, ekto kalo, ar achlao kore eshe, khub boro boro paisley koro." Ar, then I went and brought them the 2 or 3 printed saris I had. I said, "Take these with you. Whatever colors, whatever designs, just copy them." "Na didi, ami kemon hobe?" I said, "Nai chol, hotei hobe, ami to kichu bolte parchi na." So I gave them the money that they asked for schemes and for their labor and coming and going. And about 2 weeks later, my daughter Malika, who is not here today, she and I went to Shantiniketan, in those villages where these girls had given us their address. And we saw that they were in a very unhappy situation, in one little mud hut with one room and little veranda outside where they cooked and cleaned and everything. And so they also gave us mishti and shingara and chai, and we came back after talking to them and so on. But on the way back, Malika and I talked about how we could help them. And she said, "Mummy, let them bring back these clothes and let's see what we can do about that." So we waited, and 2-3 months later they came smiling from here to there. "Namaskar didi, kemon achen?" The moment I saw this, I knew that they had done a good job. They came in and we opened the saris. The kind of work they did at that time, they're not able to do anymore. Very fine, very beautiful stitching. So I told them, I said, "Me bosho." I went out and bought 4 more saris. I said, "But just copy these. Whatever you have done, just copy these." What I was going to do, what Malika was going to do, we didn't know. But we just said, "Copy these." And then soon thereafter, I had breast cancer. So it was 31 years ago. And Malika at that time was going from school to Loreto College. And then she had a lot of young friends studying in the college. So she started making kurtas, like some of you are wearing, with yokes embroidered in gantha, with sleeve panels, with backs of the kurtas and so on. She started the first lot of tailored garments in those days. And then I got better and we started doing both saris and kurtas and so on. Then Malika got married soon thereafter, 2 children and traveling and so on. So she had no time for mummy. She still doesn't have time for me. She hasn't come today, you see. So, yeah. What? Sorry? No, sorry. So life has been going on. God has been friendly. And all of you, the newspapers, magazines in Bengal are full of kanta. My friends in abroad, in Paris and in England and in America, love kanta. So we are able to sell kanta, and it's the support of people like you who come and buy kanta. doesn't matter whether they buy from me or not. It doesn't matter to me. In the Shantiniketan villages and in other places, there are lots of people doing katha privately and selling them in Delhi, Bangalore, Bombay, Chennai, everywhere. On the streets, lower costs, lower designs perhaps, but the same empowerment of women in the villages is being carried through thousands of women today. Thousands of men in